The first thing I want to say is the only way I can describe the temperature in here is freezing hot. And I keep telling my team that, and I don't know if they know exactly what that means, but I'm a fan.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's definitely not freezing hot. It's definitely just hot, and I just realized I didn't bring any blotting paper, so I'll have a glow.
There you go.
A pregnant glow.
I am really excited about your book. I actually have it pre-ordered.
Thank you so much. I can't believe my hugging lights are slicing right now.
I want to ask, you have Mayim Bialik writing your foreword, which
yes,
is so cool.
I do.
I love that choice. Can you sort of speak to why her?
She was the most famous person I knew. No, I did an L Women in Comedy event a couple years ago, and she turned out was a fan, and that blew my mind. And we got together, and she is one of the most grounded, loveliest, smartest women. And we've just developed. Also, she thinks I'm cool. Like, she thinks I'm one of the popular girls, which is hilarious to me. And she's just wonderful, and she agreed to write it. And I couldn't have been more humbled by the fact that she said yes. And she's smart.
She's very smart.
And that is really hard to come by in Hollywood.
Yes, doesn't she like actually do like research and write PhD dissertations and like...
Yeah, not just for funsies. She's a neuroscientist.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
So it's like one degree removed from like having a friend that's a doctor. Like, I always want questions. Like, do I look ill? So,
absolutely.
She's great.
I love your Freeform show. And I know you've been wanting your whole life to host your own late night show, which
you did
is amazing.
Some research.
I'm a fan, as I said. I want to ask though, what are you sort of doing on your show to differentiate it from the pretty crowded space of late night shows?
Well, I did it. It was a limited run, so we only had the 6 episodes.
And it's not coming back at all?
No, and that is, you'll have to write your...
I will.
Write your local cable network for that one.
Yeah.
But we're taking out another show. You know, this industry is all about having sticking to your guns and your at-bats. And so I think, A, it's a woman in late night. B, I want to do a show that's about talking about social things, not just politics.
Right.
While I agree with a lot of the politics out there for liberal people, I don't know if the world needs another person saying the same thing. So I want to speak on behalf of women. I want to ask questions. I want to create a learning environment versus just being angry, which I am all the time anyway.
I mean, it's central to your comedy, so
yeah,
we wouldn't have it any other way. Last thing I want to ask, why do you feel like an event like tonight is important, especially for comics to be sort of supporting and involving themselves with?
Well, you know, Ray Romano called and we all answered. And that's a lot of what comes down to it. You know, there is no bad cause. And I was saying before that comics are kind of like superheroes. Like, you put out the call and we come. So a lot of times, and this is not an example, that we just show up to charity events once invited, and there's no downside to it. You know, we love the stage time. We love helping a good cause. So something like this, you know, it's a type of bone cancer. It's something that a lot of people probably don't know about. So anytime you can shed a light on a disease that's lesser known than some of the others, you're doing a mitzvah, you're helping out, everybody gets to laugh, and I think there's a cheese block over there, so everybody's gonna win.
I'll be there and right when this is done, for sure.
Yeah,
well, hey, it was very nice to meet you, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you so much.
You got it, absolutely.
Thank you, Popcorn.